दिस ऑल्सो अकारांत पुल्लिंग वर्ड मित्र लाइक राम सो लक्ष्मीकांत सो लाइक दैट दिस इज ऑल्सो पुल्लिंग मित्र अकारांत पुल्लिंग वर्ड मूल पदम इज मित्र मूल पदम इज मित्र अकारांत सो वेन इट बिकम्स नपुंसकलिंगम इट टेक्स द फॉर्म मित्रम देन इट रेफर्स टू फ्रेंड बट वेन इट बिकम्स पुल्लिंगम देन इट टेक्स द फॉर्म मित्र विथ अ विसर्ग देन इट मीन्स डिफरेंट टोटली इट इज नॉट अ फ्रेंड इट मीन्स सन सूर्य मित्र मीन्स सूर्य मित्रम मीन्स फ्रेंड सेम मूल पदम वेन द लिंगम इज डिफरेंट देन इट कैन मीन डिफरेंट थिंग्स समटाइम्स इन दिस इज द वन एग्जाम्पल
What is Mitram's Moolapadam?
Moolapadam is Mitra. Mitra.
And for Mitram, it is Mitra only?
Yeah, both are same. Moolapadam is same.
Okay.
But when it becomes Napunsakalingam, then the form is Mitram. When it becomes Pullingam, the form is Mitraha. So the meanings are different in this case. So when we have to be careful, so while using this Mitra word. So Mitram, friend means Mitram. So let's quickly revise. Hopefully you have gone through last week we reached our end of the list of our example words. We studied Akaranta Pullinga words, Akaranta Strilinga words. Then some akaranta napumsakalinga words also, right? And some ikaranta dirgha ikaranta strilinga words. So there are examples here. We won't go through all of them again in the class. We'll see some samples here. The first one is the first one is sa mahila, because again I'm going to ask the question here. Sa mahila,
one question is that in pulling esha or in sriling esha, writing in Devanagari is same.
No, pulling is with the visarga esha. With the visarga esha, and strilinga it is esha, akaran.
But it is in the slides, it is same.
Slide is same.
Hmm.
Which one? Let me check. Maybe it's typo. Esha. Here is strilinga. Oh no no no. Sorry. Okay. Thank you. I corrected it. So we'll start with
Thank you.
Thank you. Who wants to do this? Satish Mohde, you want to try this one? Well, first you have to ask the question.
Tat kim? Tat patra. Patram.
Patram, yes. Tat patram.
Mm.
Next one.
Tat kim? But I don't know what is it. तत् किं तत् शिक्षक
सो अनदर ऑप्शन इज यू डो नॉट वी डो नॉट हैव टू यूज द सेम वर्ड्स व्हिच आर ऑन द
स्लाइड ये पुल्लिंग ये सह सह सद सह शिक्षक
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 इफ यू नो द अनदर वर्ड फॉर टीचर फॉर एग्जांपल अध्यापक यू कैन यूज इट अध्यापक ओके
पुल्लिंग
स्त्रीलिंग
स्त्रीलिंग सो एषा खा डॉक्टर आई डोंट नो डॉक्टर
वैद्य
वैद्य
आई थिंक इट इज साका
साका सॉरी साका सा वैद्य
अस्तु धन्यवादः नेक्स्ट अनुपमा भगिनी
तत् का तत् किं सॉरी तत् किं तत्
भोजनगृहं
तत् भोजनगृहं
नेक्स्ट वन
तत् किं तत्
युतकम्
युतकम् तत् युतकम् सो इफ पॉसिबल ट्राई टू यूज देम इन योर डेली लाइफ सो बिकॉज दीज आर वेरी कॉमन वर्ड्स युतकम् आई मीन जस्ट फॉर शॉर्ट एटलीस्ट यू कैन रिजर्व वन डे फॉर द यूसेज इन अ वीक इन योर एट योर होम दिस वन
तत् किम् तत्
गुड धन्यवाद नेक्स्ट कर्ता महोदय
तत् किं तत् देवालय
देवालयः पुल्लिङ्गशब्द
पुल्लिङ्गशब्द
पुल्लिङ्ग
बट दट इन्क्लूड्स इन नमस्कार
देवालयः
देवालयः तत् किं तत् देवालयः
तत् न वाट् इस् द पुल्लिङ्ग फोर् द क्वश्चन् तत् तत् इस् फोर् नपुंसकलिङ्गम्
या दिस् इस् नम्स् ओन्ली दिस् देवालय इस् नम्स् ओन्
न देवालयः इस् पुल्लिङ्ग वर्ड्
सः कः
सः कः सः देवालयः
languages it's called devalayam but not in sanskritam devalayam is some other maybe different languages so but in sanskritam it is a pullinga devalayah so sah kah sah devalayah
okay
okay this one
टूथपेस्ट दन्तफेनकं
प्रश्नः प्रश्नः
सः सः कः न एषः कः
न नपुंसकलिङ्गं
तत्
अचे यस् तत् किम् एतत् किं सोरि एतत् किम् एतत्
दन्तफेनकं
दन्तफेनकं So only Fenakam was the soap and this is Danta Fenakam.
Danta Fenakam.
So Dhanyavada, Rama Prasada. Oh,
I don't know the word of Esha Kim Esha Makaraha
Esha Kaha
Makaraha
Esha Kaha
Esha Kaha
Esha Makaraha. Esha Kaha Kim Sakaha Saha Danta Surtaha.
Do you put the pullinga Sahakaha or Eshakaha? Saka is for pulling. This one?
Tatkim Tatsetika.
No, Srilinga one. Srilinga, what is the? It is not Tat, right?
Ah. Sakim Saka Sa Petika.
Yes, good. Okay, you do the next one also.
Etat Kim Etat Amra Palam.
Good. Thank you. Next one. There is someone called Deepshika. Do you want to do this? Next one. Deepshika Avasthi. You can unmute yourself. Okay, no. All right, that's okay. Next one, Lakshmikant Mode. Lakshmikant Mode.
Etat Kim, Etat Nanakam.
Next.
Etat Kim, Tat Pushpam. Etat Kim, sorry, sa Eshaha Kaha, Eshaha Tarpunaha. Mancha Tat whether it is pulling or not, settling, I don't know.
So we are
Strilinga. Saka Sa Shaya.
Okay. Thank you. Dhanyavad. Next one, Manikandan.
This is my first class. Try from next class.
That's okay. But have you understood what we are talking like? So we are referring to the objects. How do we refer to the yukta object? So we, for example, in this case, Vruddha, old lady. Vruddha means old lady. So this is a Strilinga word. So we, in the last few classes, we talked about the few words and their lingam in gender. So basically there are three types of genders, masculine, feminine and neutral. That's called pullinga, strilinga and naposakalinga words. And to refer to these three different linga words, saha means he, saha means he, and then eshaha means he only when the object is nearby and the object is away. Saha means that, and then sa, if the word is strilinga, for example here the vruddha word is in strilinga, then we use sa vruddha, because sa means that old lady. Sa vruddha means the, if the old lady is away from the person who is talking, then the person is going to say sa vruddha. And similarly, esha vruddha, if the vruddha is close by. If the vruddha is close to me, then I would say esha vruddha. Yeah. Similarly, the next, for example, what we saw the next one. This is sharkara. Sharkara is also strilinga word, so we are going to refer to it as sa sharkara, means that sugar. Similarly, esha sharkara, if the sugar is close by. Padaha. Next one, which one, Neela Devi, you want to do this one? But Manikanth Manode, try to understand, if you any, try to understand, and if you are, when your time, go through the previous recording, class recordings, and then if you have questions, please ask me. So.
Yes, sure, sure.
Esha Danta.
Esha Dantaha.
Esha Danta. Dantaha.
प्रश्नः कः फर्स्ट प्रश्नः कः मीन्स् वाट् इस् द क्वश्चन् एषा का
माला Eshaka.
What is the next one?
Esha. Esha Rakshaka.
Pullinga word. Pullinga.
Rakshaka.
Karta Maurya, can you mute please?
Yes, Rakshak. Pullinga.
Pullinga, how do, what is the question? How do we ask the question for pullinga words? Eshaha.
Eshaha.
Eshaha kaha.
Eshaha kaha. Kam. Eshaha kaha. Rakshaka. Eshaha kaha.
Okay. So we'll stop this this revision here and move on to the next and what is this one?
Sarva. I don't know, sorry.
That's okay. So we'll sort Satish Mohde.
Don't know that. I mean, don't remember.
Don't know.
Okay.
Kanduk.
Kanduk.
Kanduk. Kaha. So.
Sahakaha.
Sahakaha. Sahakanduka.
Kandukaha. Astu. So, we'll move on to the next one. So please go through these words again and again, at least you get familiar, because we need to, the important thing is the vocabulary is to increase
okay.
in order to be able to form the sentences, right?
Okay.
Because these are day-to-day words, so if you want to talk, then we need to know the words.
Yeah.
Okay, so we'll look at few more words today, new words.
Shaha.
So this was the summary slide. Pullingam, we have saha esha kaha, strilingam, sa esha ka, the person lingam, tat etat kim. So moving on to the next slide, we'll look at few more words which are parts of our body, human body. Can you all see the screen, the diagram?
Yes.
So here, I'll start from the top here. So we'll see skandhaha. So we don't have to repeat means what this means in English, because the parts are given here. So if anybody has any questions, please ask me. So skandhaha, what is the lingam of this word? It's obvious that it is a pullinga word. Where there is nothing is written, like tattu raha, here it is a napumsakalingam word. So even the uraha, there is a visarga, then also it is a napumsakalingam word. So that is why there is tat etc. is written here. Where there is nothing is written, either it is pullingam or strilingam, depending on the form which is seen here, which is very obvious. For example, skandha, it is like balakaha or ramaha. It is a akaranta pullinga shabda. Akaranta, what is akaranta? The mula shabda, mula padam is akaranta. Skandha is not akaranta. Skandha is ending in a visarga sound. But its mula padam, skandha, is a word which ends in a sound, skandha. So here, skandha is a pullinga. So what are we going to say? Saha skandha or esha skandha. So one by one we go through these parts, words, and then you add the saha or sa or tat before the words. So you understand the lingam also there. And
Jatru is shoulder. Jatru is shoulder.
Jatru is that
collarbone or shoulder?
It is not shoulder. Collarbone, correct. Collarbone. Okay. Okay, so who has not done? Bindu Madhav. Start tat turaha, we already know. You can start with this udaram. So is it saha, sa or tat?
Sir.
Yes.
Namaste, Bindu Madhavan.
Namaste.
Udaram, should I ask the question and answer? I'm sorry.
Yeah, you can do that. Question answer, yes.
Saha kim, saha udaram. Am I right or?
No, the udaram is an apusakalingam word because here it is ending in a ma, like we
okay.
saw many.
So napumsakalingam means tat kim. Tat udaram.
Okay, good. Next one.
Tat kim, tat nabihi. Oh, this is
pullingam. Take it pullingam.
This is pullingam, sir.
Yes.
Saha kim. Saha nabihi.
No, kim is used for napumsakalingam, right?
Oh, saha kaha. Sorry, sir. Saha kaha. Saha nabihi.
Okay, next one.
Saha kaha. Saha katihi.
Okay, thank you. Next one, Suresh Mahode. Suresh Mahode. Next.
Sure.
एतत् किम् एषः कः एषः ऊरुः
द वर्ड शक्ति शक्ति इज द अपर पार्ट तत्
शक्ति
थाय तत् शक्ति अपर पार्ट ऑफ द थाय तत् शक्ति सः ऊरुः करेक्ट सः कः सः ऊरुः चुन्द्री
Sir, that uraha, why is that an exception, sir? That we don't say saha uraha, but then...
Yeah, because uraha is a napunsakalingam word. It is not exception, means there are many words like this. So, it is the nature of the word. So far, we have seen only handful of the words, like only like how many words we have seen, maybe 30 words. So, 30, all the examples we have taken so far, in the previous classes, they were like very simple words like Ramaha, Balakaha, Arakshakaha. They are all ending, the Moola Padam is ending in Akara and then all they are ending in Visarga. They are that kind of words. But there are different other kind of words like in, for example, Uraha is there. Uraha is an Napunsakalingam word because it is not a Akaranta word. Remember. What we have seen so far in the examples, for example, Rama and Balaka, these Moola words, Moola Padam, they are all ending in okay, Akaranta Pullinga. But here, in this case, this is not a Akaranta, Moola Padam is not Akaranta, this is Sakaranta actually. Okay. Uras.
Yes. Okay.
So that is why this is a different type. And Uras is an Napunsakalinga Sakaranta, sa sound, ending in sa, not a. It is not ura sound. Moola Padam is not ura, it is Uras. So Sakaranta Napunsakalinga Shabda, and when it is used in a sentence, it becomes Uraha. When it is used to refer to an object, it becomes Uraha.
Okay.
Okay.
Clear.
Next one.
So, Saka.
So Padha is over.
Padha is over. Okay.
Okay. You start from the right side here.
Eshaha kaha. Eshaha kakshaha.
Kaksha is that armpit. Okay, next.
Eshaha kaha. Eshaha pragandaha.
Praganda is the upper arm. The whole upper arm.
Okay.
Next.
Eshaha kaha, eshaha kurparaha.
Kurparaha is the elbow. Okay, next.
Eshaha kaha, eshaha parshvaha.
Side. Okay, next.
Eshaha kaha, eshaha prakoshtaha.
Prakoshta is the lower part of the arm, this part.
Eshaha kaha, eshaha panihi or eshaha karaha.
So that we know already. And this part is the complete part, is called bahu. Eshaha kaha, eshaha bahu. Arm. Astu, dhanyavadaha. Next,
Bahuhu is a full hand, huh?
No, full hand. Next one, Anupama Bhagini.
एषा का एषा कृकाटिका
कृकाटिका इज द बैक बैक पार्ट ऑफ द नेक ओके
तत् किम तत् पृष्ठम एषा का एषा जंका
we already saw jangha here
okay. esha ka esha gutika esha 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 kaha esha pashnihi pashnihi then it is esha ka then esha pashnihi
no eshah
eshah is it because it's ekaranta then which with listen I was just confused
yeah yeah some words are like that some words are feelinga some words pullinga this one is pullinga because
okay
that is how the word is no. gutika okay. means I think everybody understood gutika is ankle parshni is heel okay next padaha is the foot and prapadam prapadam is the front part of the foot
okay upper foot
upper foot okay dhanyawad next one ramaprasad mohode so we'll focus on the face
eshaka esha mastakam
oh in the previous one we forgot one thing the whole body is shariram
okay. I'm not able to see full screen
okay so yeah shariram I'll write it here shariram shariram is full body napunskalingam etat kim etat shariram but again there is another word which is very common is called deha is a pullinga word deha शरीरम और देहः एषः कः एषः देहः एतत् किम् एतत् शरीरम् but when you actually come to know the meaning of these words means meaning is same body means body right but in sanskritam as many of you already know each word has its own etymology like meaning right then when we understand that then we actually understand the beauty of this language sanskritam yeah. body means generally body body but what is shariram what is deha what is the difference shariram I mean, do you want to know it now
yes shariram I think it is no life or maybe it's other way
no both are having life it is not kalevaram shariram means the one which shiryate means one which what do you call kshina what do you call kshina one which gets destroyed slowly that is shariram okay means day by day it loses you know shariram as the body deha means it grows day by time deha so actually body has
I'm not able to see full screen
which one the one I have written
you know gutika I'm not able to see full
gutika
yeah below that
gutika hai gutika and parshni
that I am not able to see gutika word I am seeing but
you are able to say you are able to see the word
actually we are not able to see now
which on the top bottom portion
bottom
yeah
No, I can see.
Now it is.
You may be having some status bar or something which is covering it. Might
be.
Yeah. Okay, anyway, I can reduce this. Is it better?
Yeah.
Yes,
okay.
Anyway, Shariram Deha. Deha one which grows, Shariram one which gets destroyed slowly. Shariram. So that's how the words are they are coined in Sanskritam. Each word has its own meaning. Though the general meaning sounds same. But when you get into its etymology, then it bhashas.
What is the difference between prapadam and pada?
Prapadam is the top part, like see the pointing, where it is pointing.
Yeah. But whole thing can be pada, no?
Yeah, whole thing is pada, correct. Pada or charanam, same thing.
Bhutika, Parshnihi, Prapadam and Pada, whole thing can become Pada?
Yes. Prapadam, Bhutika, Parshni, they are all in Pada. Okay, next one. Ramaprasadam.
Yeah. Etat kim, etat mastakam. Yesha kaha, yesha keshaha. And I am talking from the right side of it. Etat kim etat la esha ka esha lalatam.
No, etat.
Etat kim etat lalatam. Etat kim etat kurcham. Saka sa bru, not able to read this.
Bruhu. Bru is eyelash, not eyelash. What is that? Eyebrow. Bru madhyam. The middle of the. Between the eyebrows.
Esha ka, esha kaninika.
The pupil.
Etat kim, etat netram. Esha ha kaha, esha kapolaha. Etat kim, etat shamashru.
Shmashru is the facial hair.
Esha ka, esha griva. Esha kaha, esha chibu kaha. Etat kim, etat mukham. Esha kaha, esha karanaha. Esha ka, esha nasika. Esha kaha, esha sanuho.
Esha
hanuho. Esha kaha, esha ostaha. Esha kaha, esha kantaha.
Tam etat kim, etat mastakam.
Sir, griva means neck.
Neck. So griva is neck, kantha is throat, griva is neck, and the back part of the griva is same, griva only, back part is specific, like we have got parshnihi for the back part of the foot, heel, back part of the griva is krukatika. And these are not commonly used words, but just for reference, I have given it here. So,
Prakrutika and
Sir, what is that? difference between Kapolaha and Hanuhu?
Hanu is a jaw. Hanuhu is jaw, Kapola is the cheek.
Okay.
So here the other words which are given here, for example, Karnaha, Malaha. Malaha means the dirt which inside or comes out of that karna is called pinjusham. And Nasika Malaha is Singhanam. Netra Malaha is Dushika. If you want to, if you are interested. So here it may be confusing that, you know, for example, where it is like a word like Nasika, Karnaha, Mastakam, there the lingam is clear, obvious, that Mastakam is Napunsakalingam, Karana is Pullinga, Nasika, Srilinga. But how to know this Hanuhu, like Hanuhu, Shmashru, yeah, then Bruhu. But these are again with the practice we have to get to it. Like there is no hard and fast rule that because there could be some word which sounds similar like Hanu, like Guruhu, Guru. That also like Raswa U, right? Guru is Guruhu, Hanuhu. But Guru is a Pullinga word. Hanu is a Sriling word, Sahanuhu. So how do you know that? It is not easy. But again, we have to, by practice, we'll come to know. But again, we don't have to be discouraged by these different lingas. We have to start using the words. Now, whether we make some mistakes in the beginning, it is fine. Sometimes we use Srilinga words and pulling words as Srilinga words and Napunsaka all mixed up. That is fine. But the important thing is we start using the words, mistake or no mistake. But as the time goes by, it will improve, and it should improve. We should not keep on making the mistakes for like forever.
Sir, here, what is this Malaha? Malaha.
Malaha is a dirt. Like, Malaha means dirt.
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 Oh, I see. So why that is karna after karna? Why it is written in the brackets?
Because
Malaha is basically a waste that comes out of it. So
yeah, waste.
Reporting is treating the waste that comes out of these three.
Why bracket means it is not shown here, let's say. It is not on the diagram.
Sir, regarding the previous slide where you said we can use Deha and Shariram for the body.
Mm-hmm.
Did you say that Deha is masculine? And I was trying to note it down.
Correct. Deha is the Moola Padam. Deha is a masculine word. Yeah.
Okay, sir.
Sharira
is Napunsakalinga.
Yes.
Okay, sir. Okay, thank you.
Chibukaha is a chin?
Chin, yes. That Bhajagovindam, if you know, there is a Chibuka word, right? And, so this Bhajagovindam, anybody know Bhajagovindam?
Yes, sir.
It is of Shankaracharya.
Yeah, Shankaracharya. Prushte vani, agre vani, prushte, Ratrav Udara Samarpita Janu, Chibuka Samarpita Janu. Ratrav Chibuka Samarpita Janu. So Chibuka is also there, Janu is also there.
Piva includes Krukutam and Kantabut?
No. Griva is the whole neck, complete neck.
Now, including Kantha and Kurukutika?
Yes, yeah. Kantha is the front part, right? The throat inside, actually inside throat. Yeah. Kantha is throat, Griva is neck. The Kurukutika is just the back part. Of. Okay, next you can read Lakshmikantamurthy.
Sir, what about tongue?
Tongue is coming here.
Oh, okay.
Saha kaha? Eshaha kaha? Eshaha kankarha? Eshaha kaha? Eshaha kapalha? Tat kim tat asti? Tat kim? Etat kim? Etat asti? Etat kim? Etat mastikam?
Mastishkam.
Mastishkam, sorry. Mastishkam. Eshaha kaha? Eshaha? Eshaha kaha, esha dhamanihi?
Eshaha, pulling over.
Eshaha kaha, esha snayuhu? Tat kim? Or etat kim? Etat radayam? Etat kim? Etat rudiram? Etat kim etat mausam? Saka sa kanishtika? Saka sa anamika? Saka sa madhyama? Saka sa tarjani? Esha kaha esha nukaha? एशा कहा एशा अंगुष्ठः एशा कहा एशा करभः एशा कहा एशा मणिबंधः एशा कहा एशा पाणिः एशा कहा एषः अंगुलिः एषः कः एषः हस्तः एषः कः एषः दन्तः एषः कः एषा ओष्ठः एषः कः नै सा का सा जिह्वा इतत् किं तत् और एतत् किं एतत् मुखं श्रावा इदे
So that the rasa, the lala is that the liquid thing which is in the
saliva.
Mouth.
Saliva.
Shava means secretion actually.
Secretion, yes. Sorry. Astu. So here individual. Anguli means any finger is anguli, and kanishtika are the individual names for those each finger. Kanishtika is the small finger, anamika is this one, madhyama middle finger, tarjani is this, what is it ring finger? No, I don't know. Angushtaha is the
index finger.
Huh? Index finger,
Madhyama is middle finger, Anamika is ring finger,
right. And Kanishtika is index finger. Tarjani is index finger.
Index finger, yeah. Okay. So, Karabha is the soft part between, from this root of this, base of this Hasta to the base of the Kanishtika. That part is Karabha. Panihi. or hastaha. Panihi we saw karaha. Panihi and karaha we saw in the last slide. Same. You're right, panihi karaha. But hastaha means you see a hasta technically, though sometimes we keep on using pani, hara, karaha, hastaha, all interchangeable, but technically hastaha means this whole thing. The lower part of the arm and the pani together is hasta.
So there is a small distinction. Panihi is actually above the panibandha. Karaha includes panibandha.
Right, and also it includes, as defined in the kosha, it also includes the lower part of the arm, hasta. So here, prakoshta plus pani is hasta, as a hastaha. That is what Amarakosha says. These are all from Amarakosha, all these words. Okay, so we can just practice them at home, review them. And then next one, we'll see a few words which are, again, everyday use. Pakashala sambandhini vastuni is the word. The things which are related. Kitchen.
Kitchen.
Pakashala is kitchen. So, esha pakashala. So, this is kitchen. Why is it esha?
Strilinga.
Pulinga.
Strilinga. Pakashala word is strilingam. Strilinga word. Strilinga padam. Strilinga padam. That's why this esha is, esha we have to use esha, because that is strilinga. We can't use esha.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes. Esat. We can use sa if you want. Sa pakashala. So others are shulika, fork. Chamasaha is spoon. Chamasaha. Pullinga, strilinga, remember, these are easy words to know what is the lingam, because chamasa, we have seen so many words like this, balakaha, ramaha, etc. Shulika, this strilinga word, like sharkara, balika, so mahila, so on. Churika also strilinga, thalika is also strilinga. Strilinga padam. Shulika, chamasaha, churika, sthalika. Next one, Neela Devi, can you read this?
Sir?
Yeah, can you read this? You can use saha, sa or tat with these words.
Tat, chapka. Shamkam, chapkam, shashkam, shashkaha.
So what is the lingam?
Pullingam.
Pullingam. So it cannot be tat. So what should be used?
Tat pullingam, sir.
No, no. Tat is not pullingam, right? Tat is napunsakalingam. Saha is pullingam.
Saha. Saha is pullingam.
Sa is the strilingam. And
saha tat is. Saha. Sa. Tat.
So with chashaka, what word? We should we use saha or should we use sa or should we use tat?
Saha chupukaha.
Chashakaha. Saha chashakaha.
Chashakaha.
Chashakaha. Chashakaha means this object.
Chashakaha means glass.
Glass. Okay, this one. Next.
Chashaka. Chaska. gani chakaha gani cup
no no chashaka dhani is cup holder so chashakaha means it could be glass or it could be cup no? Either one of them chashakaha
lower part of it.
No, no, no. Chashakaha is only cup.
No. Chashakathani is called saucer, no? Saucer.
Saucer, okay. Chashakathani is which holds the cup, which holds the chashaka.
Yes. That is saucer, sir.
Right, okay. So what is the lingam? It is like Saraswati.
Saraswati is Sri Lingam.
Sri Lingam. So, Chashakathani is also Sri Lingam. So Sa Chashakathani.
Srilingam.
Correct. So what word will come here? Saha or Sa or Tat?
Sa.
Sa. Okay.
Sa.
Okay. What about the next one?
Adanika. Adanika. Sa. Sa Adanika.
Good. Sa Adanika.
Sa Adanika.
Okay, next.
Velani.
Sa Velani. Good. Thank
you. Sa Velani.
Good. Thank you. Okay, next. So Girish Mohdai, do you want to do this? Are you there? Girish Mohdai?
Yes, I'm there, but I cannot see the board. I'm on the phone.
Oh, phone, okay. No problem.
Thank you.
Thank you. Okay. Next, Satish Mohdai.
Yes, sir. Saha kaha, saha ghatagaha.
Ghataha.
Ghataka. Okay. Darvi. Okay. So sa darvi.
Yes. Good. So next.
Saha kadagaha. Kadagaha.
Kataha.
Kadagaha.
Kataha.
Kadagaha. Okay.
Hold on. So, see, there is a difference between ta and da, right?
Okay.
So, this is ta. Ka, ta, ha, ha.
Okay. Kataha.
Kataha. Next.
Kataha. Tad, mishra. Mishragam.
Mishraka. Ka and ga should be pronounced properly. Ga is different, okay. Ka is different. Mishrakam.
Okay. Mishrakam.
Next.
Sa ma manantah. Manantana.
Manthanaha.
Mandanaha.
Manthanaha.
Mandanaha.
Next.
Tad peshagam.
Peshakam.
Peshakam.
Okay. Dhanyavada. Next.
Yeah.
Bindu Madhava.
Yes, sir.
Yep.
Sir, Kim. Sa Anila Chulli. Chulli.
So here Anila Chulli, as it is shown here, it is Sa, it is Trilinga. Hmm?
Oh, okay.
Hmm. Okay.
So I should say Sahaha, Sahaha Kim, Sahaha Anila Chulli.
One second.
Saka.
Sir?
Sa, right? Trilinga is Sa.
Okay. Oh, sorry. Sorry, sir. Okay.
No, there's no need for sorry. So the question is ka, right? Sa and ka. Sa ka, sa anila chullihi.
Sa ka, okay. Okay, sir.
Okay.
Sa ka, sa anila chullihi.
Hmm. Okay. Next, this one.
Sa ka, sa indanam.
No. Is it, what lingam? Lingam. Padasya.
Okay.
What is the lingam of the padam?
Is it napumsaka lingam?
Yes, yes, yes. Like shariram, napumsaka lingam.
Tat, so we should say tat kim.
Yes, yep.
Tat kim, tat indanam.
Hmm. And this one?
Tat kim, tat vashpaha.
So, what is the lingam? What? How does the word look like?
No? Oh, sorry, sir. It is just like this Anila Chulli.
No, no. Anila Chulli is Trilinga. This Vashpaha looks like Balakaha. Balakaha, Ramaha.
Okay. So, it is Napumsaka Lingam.
Pullinga. Balaka.
Pullinga.
Pullingam, okay, sorry, sorry, pullingam.
So pullinga, okay. What is the word?
What is the word? Eshaha kaha.
Yes, yep.
Eshaha bashpaha.
Yes, good. Next.
This patram must be in feminine gender, I think.
Why feminine? It is like indanam, right?
Oh, okay, sir.
Hmm.
Okay, sorry. Tat kim, tat patram.
Hmm. Good. Okay, next. Roni.
I'm not able to identify the gender, sir.
No, so what? Think of the words which you have done so far, okay? So, compare them with how do they sound like. For example, Bashpaha sounds like Ramaha, Balaka. Only just you can remember couple of the words, like from the slides we have seen so far. So couple of words from Pullinga, couple of words from Strilinga, couple of words from Napumsakalingam. For example, we saw Rukshaha, Balakaha, those are Pullinga, so it looks like that. And in Indhanam, Patram, we saw what? We saw many words. For example, what are the words we saw in Napumsakalingam? Anybody remember?
Indhanam is Napumsakalinga.
But what are the other words we saw in Napumsakalingam?
Chashakam.
Vanam. No, Chashakam.
Chashakam, sorry. Vanam.
Patram.
Correct. Yes. Patram. Patram is a common word. Patram. Vanam is an Napumsakalingam. And Kankatam.
Mapika. Shariram also we saw, sir. Shariram.
Yeah, shariram. So you compare those words and then new word which comes along, how does it look like? You can guess the lingam. It may not be 100% correct, but mostly it will be correct.
Okay, sir. Tat kim tat droni.
No, tatna. Droni is like what? Droni is like what word we remember? Saraswati, Nadi.
Oh.
Trilling.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
So
it is
ending in Dirghai. Dirghai. Nadi, Saraswati.
Okay, sir. Sa kim.
Kim?
Sa or Isha kim or Sa kim? Sa droni.
No, Sa is, Isha is correct, but what is the question? It cannot be kim. Kim is for Napumsakalingam.
Oh, sorry, sir. Sa kaha.
Sa?
Sa kaha.
Ka.
Ka, okay.
Yeah.
Sa ka, sa droni.
Okay, and the next one, last one on this slide.
This one, sa kim, sa విద్యుచ్చులి
ఎలక్ట్రిక్ స్టోవ్ సో విద్యుచ్చులి సో హియర్ వి ఆర్ సేయింగ్ సా బికాస్ ఇట్ ఇస్ ఆల్రెడీ గివెన్ హియర్ వి ఆర్ ఆన్ ద సేమ్ స్లైడ్ వి ఆర్ చుల్లి వర్డ్ ఇస్ స్త్రీలింగ సో హియర్ ఆల్సో స్త్రీలింగ సో ద క్వశ్చన్ ఇస్ సా
కా
కా సా కా
అస్తు
ధన్యవాద అస్తు నెక్స్ట్ చుంద్రి హౌ డు యూ సే యువర్ నేమ్ చంద్రి ఆర్ చంద్రి
ఇట్స్ యాక్చువల్లీ చంద్రిమా సార్ ఐ హావ్ గివెన్ ఇట్ అస్ CHUNDRI
ధన్యవాద చంద్రిమా ఓకే
సహ అగ్నిః
So here, Saha is written here particularly to make it clear that Agni is a Pullinga because in the last slide we saw Chullihi. So Chullihi and Agni, they sound similar, right?
Mm-hmm.
Agni and Agnihi, Chullihi, they sound similar but the Lingam is different. Chullihi is Sri Lingam but Agni is Pullingam. That is why this Sa is given and Sa and Saha is given there.
Sa is for Mulapada, sir. Sa is given for the Mulapada?
No. Sa is there to indicate the Lingam of the word.
Okay.
Yeah, Sa or Saha is to make it clear what is the Lingam of the word. So.
Okay.
Okay.
Sa. కా సా జలకూపి పరశు ఏతత్ కిం ఏతత్ కష్టం
సో యు సీ హియర్ ద వర్డ్స్ విచ్ ఆర్ ఎండింగ్ ఇన్ ఆ which are ending in like Anuswara Amma. So those are clear, like mostly, like 99% or mostly they are three linga and sometimes they are not right. Our guess might be wrong, but mostly that is the pattern. So Sikta Vartika is three linga, which is ending in A. Anuswara Kastham would be the Napumsakalinga word. Kupi Dirghayi is again a three linga word. But where there is a more confusion is going to happen, like Parashu, Agni, Agni, Chulli. So they are like Anjali, for example, Avalihi. Yeah, we saw Avali. You know Avali? What is Avali? Avali is a line. Yeah. Avalihi is Trilinga word. Whereas just now in the few slides back, Angulihi was there. What is Anguli?
Finger.
Finger.
Anguli is thumb. Huh?
Finger. Angurtha is thumb. Angulihi is a pullinga word. Whereas Avalihi is strilinga word. Agnihi is pullinga word. Chullihi is strilinga word. So where there is a Hraswa Ikara, or there is little bit confusion. Okay. So, just by practice, we will come to know. Agni, obviously, I mean, it is easy to know.
Sir, as a common rule, if the E sound is very short, then it is supposed to be strilinga.
No, well, this is also, Agni is also short E, that is pullinga. Anguli is short E, that is pullinga.
Yes, sir. And if E is long, E, then strilinga. General rule.
No, it is not general rule. See, here avalihi is a shorti, it is trilinga. Chulli, it is shorti, it is trilinga, right?
Now I ask about the long e.
Yeah, long e is
e.
Long e is mostly strilingam.
Yeah.
Short e could be like 50-50, right? Some are strilinga, some
yes.
But dirgha e mostly strilinga. I'm saying, remember this, mostly underline that. Mostly strilinga. But there could be some words which are pullingam. Similarly, parashuhu is pullinga here. Saha parashuhu. Okay, next. Who wants to do this? Monica, do you want to try? Monica, are you there?
Yes, I am here.
Do you want to try or you just want to listen?
I can try, but I'm not sure. Thank you.
Yeah, go ahead, no problem. What is this word? Dhumaha. This is a long oo. Long oo. Okay. Dhumaha. Dhuma is smoke. Dhuma. What is the gender of the word? What is the lingam? So this word is like Balakaha, right? Balakaha or Ramaha. So what are the lingam of those words? Balaka means boy. Right? Balakaha, boy. Rukshaha means tree. Masculine.
Sahakaha.
So this also should be masculine. Sahakaha, correct.
Sahakaha. Thank you.
Sahadhuma. Okay, what is this one now? Next one.
Kashtam. Etat kim etat kashtam.
So this one is an apamishakalingam or a neuter gender, because this sounds like vanam. This sounds like vanam. Vanam is an apamishakalingam or neuter gender.
Okay.
So you should find out like how the sound, how the words
work. It's echoing. So please.
Sorry, I think you need to mute.
People are not talking.
Not talking in between. So if you are not talking, can you please mute your line, please? Anupama Bhagini, mute yourself or I don't mute you. Okay, that's fine. Thank you, Monica. Thank you. You can mute yourself.
Thank you.
Okay, next is Suresh Mode. Next. Let's quickly finish this. Suresh Amol.
Yeah. So questions are required or just read out the words?
No, question is not required, but say sar, esha, saha or whatever, like, so that lingam is clear.
Esha, Bashpastani. Esha Suchiti. Esha Agrapetika. Agnipetika. Esha Chulli. Esha Apakaha. Apakaha. Esha Sodhani. Esha Agnishali.
Agnishalaka.
Agnishalika.
Agnishalaka.
Esha Agnishalaka.
Somebody had a question?
So I have a doubt.
Yeah.
This Sujuti and Chulli and that is a Striling, sir.
Strilingam, yes.
So that's we should use Sa only, not Esha.
Esha or Sa, both are okay, right? Both. If it is close by, you use Esha. If it is away, you use Sa.
And no, Sa, Strilingam.
Strilingam, Sa.
That's Strilingam. So these words are actually Strilling only. So Sa should be used. That's what I have to.
No. What is your question?
No. No, the question
is when we want to say that it is far away, Esha can be used when we want to say this it is close by. So here I can say Esha Chulli or Sa Chulli. When I say Esha Chulli, it basically denotes it is closer to me.
Esha, if the object, if the suchuti or something is close by, you can use Esha. And if it is away, you can use Sa.
And Sa is not for Strilinga. Sa is for something which is far away, and Esha is something which is for near.
No. So when I say, when I say Sa Bashpasthali, Sa Bashpasthali. So that means Bashpasthali, this pressure cooker is away. Means what the complete sentence, meaning of the sentence is that is pressure cooker. Sa Bashpasthali means that is pressure cooker. Okay. Because Bashpasthali is a Strilingam word, we are using Sa word here. We cannot use we cannot use saha, or we cannot use tat. I cannot make the sentence called saha bashpasthali or tat bashpasthali. So when I want to say that is pressure cooker, I will use sa bashpasthali. Who asked the question just now? Not the question. Somebody said about Lingam. What is Chandrima?
It's me, sir. Chandrima. Actually, the person was asking the doubt, telling me, it is Strilinga, Esha means, so I just wanted to clarify.
No. Sa itself doesn't mean Strilinga. Sa.
Yeah. I know that, but the other person who initially told, I don't know who was that.
Satish Mohde, what was the question?
I didn't ask because I know that actually. Somebody else asked.
Who was asking? So, Suresh. Who was asking? What is
Suresh? I think I asked, sir.
Yeah. So that thing is clear, means Esha is.
That is clear.
Yeah. Okay. So we'll stop here today. And we'll start with the new topic next week called some more words to form the sentence. The actual becoming familiar with some of the words with the lingam, we'll wrap up that. And please go through these words again and again. And if you cannot remember the lingam without looking at it, do not worry. Just start using them. But as you start using them, as you progress, like after a few days, you will come to know when you can start using saha, deha, eshaha, balakaha, saha, suryaha, like that you can start using. Then once it becomes practice, then it will be easy to remember. But
sir, I have a specific suggestion. If you give some homework to us, specific homework, I think it will serve in a better way, so that better advancement.
Okay. I thought people don't like homework. Okay.
that will help us.
Yeah.
I mean, we're not in school anymore, so we should do our own homework.
Right. Okay, so I got a bunch of homework for you. So I will send that in the email. And if you have the, hopefully, does everyone has book, that Abhyasa Pustakam?
No, sir.
Yes, it's available.
But you can download also, right? The
downloading is good.
Yeah, ideally you buy it, that you need to buy it, but until you buy it, at least you should have that electronic copy, soft copy. So from there also, I can give you specify some page numbers, you can do the homework from there. Okay?
Yeah, if you can give it the page number, it's okay.
Yeah, okay. All right. Thank you. Dhanyavada.
One more question. How to save our
How to know?
How to save all these things for our future practicing? Whatever slides or whatever classroom.
How to slow the link is given, right? On the page.
Sir, we can just access it only. We cannot download it, sir.
No, we have to save it or download it.
Can't download it? Okay, you want to download it? Is that okay? I will send it to you.
Okay. I bought the book, but it is taking time.
No. Okay, I didn't know that. I'll see how I can make it downloadable. Okay, thank you.
Sir, in your Gmail, always that link is there.
Yeah, the link is there, but they are saying that they cannot download the slides. They can
We cannot download at least. Yeah.
It is right. I mean, I tried even.
Is it the slides you are talking about?
Yeah.
The slides.
Slides can be downloaded. We have to go to the left side. When you go there on the left side, then under, I have downloaded it. I think it's under file. If you click the file, then under that there is download. And in the download, you can also specify whether you want PowerPoint or PDF and so on.
Okay, anyway, I will check it. If it is not there, I will enable it. And then also note that these slides, the future slides may keep on changing, right? Because as a new content.
What I think, the save option should be. Save option.
Okay, I will check it. Okay. If not, I will send you the PDF. Okay, thank you.
Okay, thank you. Dhanyavada.
See you next class.
Dhanyavada.
Sanjeeva Mohodaya.
Dhanyavada Mohodaya.